Jerash, often referred to as the Pompeii of the East, is one of the best preserved Roman provincial towns in the world. Located in Jordan, approximately 48 kilometers north of the capital, Amman, Jerash boasts a rich history that spans thousands of years. The history of the city dates back to the Neolithic period, but it gained prominence during the Hellenistic era under the rule of Alexander the Great in the 4th century BC. This place, known as Grossa in ancient times, flourished significantly during the Roman epoch. Jerash became part of the Roman Decapolis, a group of 10 cities on the eastern frontier of the Roman Empire around 63 BC. The city reached its zenith during the 2nd century CE under the reign of Emperor Hadrian. Jerash boasts one of its most iconic features, known as the Oval Plaza, or commonly referred to as the Forum. This distinctive elliptical-shaped public space spans approximately 1,000 square meters and is encircled by 56 Ionic columns. It served as a central hub for social, political, and commercial activities, epitomizing the bustling heart of the ancient city. The Cardo Maximus, Jerash's main colonnaded street, stretches from north to south, adorned with columns and paved with stones that retain the imprint of ancient chariot wheels. This bustling thoroughfare, 800 meters long and 13 meters wide, served as the lifeline of the city, teeming with merchants and citizens. Jerash is home to two remarkable structures, the South Theater and the North One. The South Theater, with a seating capacity of over 3,000 spectators and an estimated floor area of 1,600 square meters, was used for public meetings and performances. The smaller North Theater, serving more intimate gatherings and council meetings, has a seating capacity of approximately 800 spectators and an estimated floor area of around 760 square meters. The Temple of Artemis is one of Jerash's most magnificent structures. Dedicated to the city's patron goddess, this part with a floor area of 162 square meters originally featured 32 Corinthian columns, each intricately carved, though only 11 of them standing today. Another significant temple is the Temple of Zeus, located near the South Theater, covering a floor area of 122 square meters, was surrounded by 15 columns. During the Byzantine period, Jerash continued to thrive and became an important center for Christianity. As a result, several churches were added to this complex. The most impressive one was the Church of Saint Cosmos and Saint Damian, which is situated near the western end of the Cardo Maximus. This building covers approximately 280 square meters and has a floor mosaic depicting a variety of animals, plants, and geometric designs. The Jerash Nymphium is a grand public fountain dedicated to the nymphs, constructed in 191 CE. This elaborately decorated structure featured water cascading into a basin, providing a refreshing communal space. Its facade includes intricate carvings, niches, and Corinthian columns, showcasing the wealth and sophistication of Jerash during the Roman period. The Arch of Hadrian was built in honor of Emperor Hadrian's visit to Jerash. This monumental arch stands as a symbol of the city's prosperity and its significance within the Roman Empire. Originally, it was intended to be the southern gate of the city, but the urban expansion never reached it, leaving the arch as a standalone landmark. The Hippodrome in Jerash is a massive arena with a floor area of approximately 12,200 square meters that hosted chariot races and other public spectacles, with a seating capacity of around 15,000 spectators. It exemplifies the Roman tradition of entertainment. Today, reenactments and performances in Hippodrome give visitors a glimpse into the grandeur and excitement of ancient Roman sports. The Northern Tetraplon is a four-sided monument marking the intersection of two major colonnaded streets. Each side of the Tetraplon originally featured a column topped with a statue, signifying its importance as a central point in the city's layout. Although much of it is in ruins, the structure's remnants still hint at its former grandeur. The carvings on the columns in Jerash are exquisite examples of ancient artistry, reflecting the city's rich cultural and architectural heritage. The columns are adorned with intricate carvings and geometric patterns, demonstrating the high level of craftsmanship achieved by Roman artisans. Complementing these carved columns are the vibrant mosaics that decorate the floors and walls of various structures throughout Jerash. These mosaics, celebrated for their complex geometric patterns, mythological themes, natural motifs, and depictions of everyday life, provide valuable insights into the artistic sensibilities and daily experiences of the ancient inhabitants. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section, and if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.